Welcome to my next video on radicals. In this video, I'll be discussing dividing radicals. Just like multiplication, division and multiplication both work well with radicals. It's part of the multiplication-division world. When we're dividing, as long as the radical are the same, we can rewrite this problem as the square root of 10 divided by 5, which is the square root of 2. And we're done. If the radical on top and the radical on bottom, numerator and denominator, are the same, just rewrite the whole fraction under one radical. On the flip side, if you have a fraction written under one radical, you can split it up into the square root of 25 divided by the square root of 81. Square root of 25 is 5, the square root of 81 is 9. And we can reduce numerator and denominator separately. On my third example, I have the square root of 28. Well, for the square root of 28, I'm going to have to do a little bit of prime factorization. So I take my 28. This is 4 times 7, 2 times 2. So this becomes the square root of 2 times 2 times 7 divided by the square root of 3. In the numerator, I see that I have a pair of 2s that can be taken out of that radical. I also notice none of the numbers in the numerator divide by 3. So my next step in my problem, I have 2 times the square root of 7 over the square root of 3. You might be thinking, this is great, I'm done, that wasn't too bad. The one problem is there is this practice in math that says we need the denominator to be an integer, preferably a natural number, positive counting numbers. So we do something called rationalizing the denominator. And in rationalizing the denominator, we need to multiply some form of 1, an interesting form of 1, to the numerator and denominator to clear that radical out of the denominator. So what we need to do to get rid of the square root of 3 is to square it. But we're not squaring the fraction because we don't have an equal sign, and that just isn't going to maintain our fraction. What we need to do is we need to multiply this by 1. Because if you multiply a fraction by 1, you don't change it. 1 times anything is itself. But instead of just 1, we'll multiply it by 1 over 1. So this is getting closer to what I want. But what I really want is something that'll take that square root of 3 and make the square root go away. So what I really want is the square root of 3 over the square root of 3. What this does is it takes that square root of 7 in the numerator and turns it into a square root of 21, which is fine. We don't care if the numerator is ugly. We only care about the denominator. And then we have the square root of 3 times the square root of 3, which is the square root of 3 times 3. They pair, come out, and we're left with a 3. We've now rationalized our denominator because what's in the denominator is a counting number, no square root. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you do, like and share, and please enjoy some of my other videos. Thank you.